I'm loving my stay here on the island, and it is just a cherishable place. I love it. Well, I'm going to start the program tonight with some, I'm going to be playing a lot of original compositions tonight. And the first one has a very French flavor to it, so enjoy.
Thank you.
talking something today. Usually, I jump up really quick and I turn off the song because the next one starts. And there's just a little button you push, and it just, it's all by itself, it stops. Thank you, Steve. And I want to thank Steve very much for doing the sound and getting things all working for the show tonight. I also want to thank everybody that made it possible for this week to happen. I think it's just a marvelous harp festival. And I go to a lot of them, so you've really got something special here on the island. Thank you. I'm going to play two Irish tunes for you right now. And this is also a very special harp. It's a carbon fiber harp. So it may have a little bit different sound to it, but there's something very unique about this harp. It's light as a feather.
Thank you.
It's so special being on an island. And how many people live here? Okay. Very special. You have all of the elements. You have the air, you have the mountains, you have the water, you have the earth. And so you have it all, really, living on an island. My son lives on Maui, so I love to visit him and my grandchildren there. My favorite place in the whole wide world of traveling is the Isle of Iona. And Iona is just one of those places where the veil is so thin. And I've been there a couple times doing silent retreats. And the only thing I take with me is just a little manuscript pad. And when you're in a silent retreat on Iona, there are no cars because they don't allow the cars there. If you don't want to have to talk to anybody or have anybody talk to you, you just put your hands in front of you and you're on your merry way. And you become very close to all the stones and the chickens and the cows and the lambs on the island. And everything becomes very magnifying. So I went for a week retreat. And when I was there, I kept hearing music. I mean, all these wonderful gifts coming out of the sky. And I'd like to share some of those with you. I'm not going to play the whole song, but I'd like to share the feeling of the music with some of the pictures to go with it. And I'd like to do it on the small harp, so you can hear that there's a lot of music that can be played on the small harp. You don't have to have a whole bunch of strings. And the word Eksha is Gaelic, and it means at the brink of the waters, the divine inspiration, and that's certainly what happened to me. So, let's get the small harp. On the island, let's see, I think you can probably hear me without me speaking in there. On the island, we have the white strand of the monks. The white strand of the monks is where, during, say, the Columbus time, the monks would be baptized at the white strand. And there's always been a white mare on the Isle of Iona, and it was the white mare of St. Columba. And on this one, I'm pretty sure it's not a mare, but sometimes their white mare actually passes away, and then they get another one, and they're in between the horses the last time I was there. I wrote a song called White Mare, and another one called The Well of the Eternal Youth. And there's a mountain called Dunee. And it's not very high, but once you get up there, you find this beautiful bubbling little well. And it's said that if you take and wash your face with the waters, that you'll have eternal youth. And this is a picture from up on top of Dunee. And of the white stranded monks, and the white sands are beautiful. Has anybody been to Iona? Raise your hand. Oh my goodness. Oh, a trip you must take. I say so myself. And here it is. This is where I did most of my composing. I sat at the edge of the water there and looked down there. That was my favorite space. And there's a lot of different stories about Iona. One is the fairy mound. And this little mound here, it's said that there are fairies dancing all around it. And then there's quite some stories too, and I'll let you find those stories out for yourself. But walking down there, I had this little tune in my head, and so that became a tune, of which are on the Iona CD in the back, if you like it. I think one of the most wonderful things that happened for me was I was sitting at the water out at the white strand, and there were rays in the sky. This isn't the particular one because it didn't happen from the sun. It happened from the clouds. And I wrote a song called Sky's Invitation. And what is kind of unique about that song is it's written in what we call fourth octave overtones. And I belong to an association since I work in hospice and the work we do in therapeutic heart, where people who have been in accidents and they've been pronounced dead have heard music on the other side. And when they actually come to hear music on earth, the closest that comes to the music to the other side is what we call fourth octave overtones. And it's a series of sounds that are the same frequencies as each of the planets spinning in space. So apparently, Pythagoras was able to say this is what we call the music of the spheres. And so that particular song, on the album, has that fourth octave overtone. There's a very special place on the island, and it's called the Hermit Cell. And it took me 3 years to find it, because every time I set out to find it, I'd get trapped into a place where I couldn't get over the fences, the electric fences. So I'd have to keep going back out, and then was pretty disappointed because I really wanted to find the Hermit Cell. And I mean, this is only a mile wide island and 3 miles long. And you'd think I did it, could do it, but I eventually found it. And you can see the waters up there looking across the wall. And it is believed that the monks from St. Columba's time actually had a hand in illuminating the Book of Kells. And it's believed that some of that illumination was done in this particular spell, which would have been built up with a thatched roof on top. And the monks would be illuminating by candlelight or whatever it was that they used at the time. So I wrote a song called The Hermit Cell. And that's one of the songs I'm going to play for you. But before I do that, I'd like to play you the song In the Glow, because everything about the island glowed. So first is In the Glow.
Thank you.
beautiful formations. So this song is called The Wild Geese.
Thank you.
And if you're lucky, you find a precious stone. And right now, I'd like you to hear just a little bit. This is actually a very fascinating song, but it was done in the studio, so I'm just going to play you a little bit of what the melody sounds like. So picture the stones. Tranquility, Reflections, and then she'll come up for Harbor Cove. Oh, gee, oh, yeah, please turn the light. You can see. Okay, let's see. For those who are not familiar with what I'm doing, this is a Celtic harp. And you make sharps and flats with the levers here.
Thank you.
certainly the genius of the folk harp, and to be absolutely revered in the harp world. And I'm sure there's many harp people. They came to the festival this week, and it was a real honor for you to have her as your teacher. So I'm going to play a Scandinavian tune and a Paraguayan tune, and then we're going to take a break. And the first one is Swedish, and it's called Finbo. And I think the second one is Finnish, I'm not sure. And I think it's called Sakturiver or something like that. And then piece that I'm playing for you, the Paraguayan piece, is by Alfredo Orlando Ortiz. And I had the absolute privilege of filling one of the things on my bucket list last March. We had a conference in San Diego, where I'm living now, and he came and we got to play this as a duet. So I'll be sitting there hearing his part too.
Thank you.
we're going to